It's been a hard day's night. 93.5, 1590 WAKR. You hear that? A hard day's night. I should be sleeping. That's the Beatles in song. But when I get home to you, we're going to talk about the Beatles in the movies now. With us is our film study professor, Joe Fortunato, as we go to film school on the Ray Horner Morning Show, 93.5, 1590 WAKR, A Hard Day's Night, released in July of 1964. And Joe, why don't you take it from there about this movie, A Hard Day's Night, my friend?
Well, good morning, Ray. Good morning, everybody. Yeah, we're doing something a little different today with A Hard Day's Night, starring, of course, the Beatles. This was directed by Richard Lester, who also directed their follow-up movie, Help, as well as Superman 2 and 3, years later, some of my favorites growing up. It was the first of several features that would feature and star the Beatles. It got nominated for two Oscars, believe it or not, Best Writing, since it's kind of a loosey-goosey kind of script, and Best Music, not surprisingly. This is really kind of the film that started it all. This is where John, Paul, George, and Ringo kind of became established as individual personalities. This movie, A Hard Day's Night, might be more responsible for their enduring image as a cultural icon than any song they made. When it came out in 1964, it was just a few months after their appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show that really launched them globally. And they had been making music for a few years prior to that in Europe. But A Hard Day's Night really captures the band when they were still, relatively young, innocent, provincial, things like LSD and Yoko Ono and Maharishi and the psychedelic era that was going to follow them in just a few short years was really not even on the radar at this point. A Hard Day's Night clicked not only with the kids that were already Beatlemaniacs, but, also with some adults who previously had just seen them as sort of a haircut band. So it's really an important movie in historically, as well as just a fun one. And not for nothing, what you're kind of seeing here is maybe the first music video, although a 90-minute long one, but it was certainly, that kind of importance. The original title of the film was just simply The Beatles, then Beatlemania. But then Ringo Starr, who was exhausted after a long day of hard work, coined the phrase A Hard Day's Night. Everyone thought that was great. The studio used that, wanted to use it as the title. And so then John and Paul went in and basically had a race to see who could come up with a song for that phrase and the movie title first. And John actually wrote the title track in one sitting and one night.
Wow, I didn't realize that. So the movie was before the song, huh?
Yeah,
exactly. Wow, interesting. Yeah. Okay, so talk about the filming. I love it when you take us behind the scenes, the filming and the plot and everything. The plot is kind of like the grandfather and everything of Paul McCartney, but they did a lot of filming on location, including trains.
Yeah, I mean, it was kind of a crazy. I mean, this was in full Beatlemania. The writer, Alan Owen, actually kind of put together the plot of the movie while following the Beatles around on their tour of France before they came to America. And from observing them, he sort of created their stereotypes that we've kind of come to know. John Lennon is the wisecracking smart guy. Paul is the cute and sensible one. George is the quiet and shy. And Ringo is sort of, the sad or funny one. These are the personas that they kind of, went with during the whole Beatlemania era. George Harrison actually met his future wife, Patty Boyd, who was played a tiny role in the movie. So that was pretty important for him. The line that Ringo says, when a reporter, people who might have remembered the film, a reporter asks him, "Are you a mod or a rocker?" And he says, "I'm a mocker," which was voted the number 58 best movie line in Premiere Magazine in 2007. And another thing I love here is before the movie was released in America, a United Artists executive asked director Richard Lester to dub the voices of the group with mid-Atlantic accents, thinking they couldn't understand, you know, their heavy Liverpool accents. And Paul sort of angrily replied, look, if we can understand a cowboy talking Texan, they can understand us talking Liverpool.
I love it. A Hard Day's Night, film study professor Joe Fortunato with us on WAKR. We normally talk about casting, but obviously the four focal points are the Beatles. But were there some other interesting stories or anything pertaining to casting of this film, Joe?
Well, you're right. I mean, you know, obviously this is, you know, for the Beatles and it stars the Beatles. But a few little nuggets in that area. Oscar-nominated actress Charlotte Rampling, this was her theatrical movie debut in a very small role. And a young Phil Collins actually appeared in the audience during one of the numbers, although that was cut from the movie. You know, there's some interesting, you know, sidelights of that kind of nature. You know, another thing about production that I wanted to share is just to show you how crazy it was during this Beatlemania period. On the first day of shooting, which was the train sequence you mentioned, that was all lost because the clapper loader, who's one of the crew members, was mistaken by fans at the train station as one of the Beatles. And he was running away from these screaming fans. He dropped the cans of the film negative.
Oh.
So they lost the first day of shooting, which is a pretty serious thing. Cost a lot of money, obviously. But, you know, it kind of just is indicative of how crazy Beatlemania was when particularly young girls were chasing the Beatles, you know, all over England and all over wherever they were.
No doubt about it. There you go. Film school today. Joe Fortunato, our film study professor, taking us on A Hard Day's Night, released in July of 1964. Great stuff again, my friend Joe. We'll reconvene next Friday morning with more film school information. Thanks for the time, Joe.
Thanks, Ray.
There you go. Joe Fortunato, film study professor. He joins us Fridays at this time as he takes us to film school.
You know I work all day to get your money to buy a
25 minutes after 8 o'clock. Those soft hits with Tim Doherty coming up at 9. Bobby in for Lynn today. Bobby Horpath takes over at 2. 62 degrees, WAKR.